Next question is from a sister. I am not allowed to wear niqab in the house in front of relatives, non-mahrams. Rather, I am forced to sit down with them and socialize. Will it be sinful for me to do this?
Of course it is sinful, and it's not permissible for you to accept. If you were to tell me that, for example, my father-in-law forces me not to wear the niqab, the face cover, only to cover my face and wear my abaya normally in front of my in-laws, I would say that this is an issue of dispute. And if we look at the fact that it would lead to divorcing the woman and destroying the marriage and what happens afterwards, maybe we can find a solution case by case scenario. But to say that not to wear the hijab, or to say that you have to sit and mix with non-mahrams, this is totally a red line that cannot be crossed. Even if it causes divorce, there's nothing wrong with divorce when it is for the sake of Allah and to run away with your religion. You can't stay too long in such a joint family, which unfortunately most of the people in the subcontinent embrace as religious. To have your son, your daughter-in-law with other sons and daughters-in-laws living in the same house. And if I tell you the amount of infidelity, the amount of zina that takes place, the amount of sexual harassment, you maybe will turn your hair gray like mine. I have so many problems. I do a lot of counselings, alhamdulillah, marriage counselings. And I have real life cases of the brother-in-law harassing his sister-in-law because the husband is traveling overseas trying to earn money. And this woman is living with them in the same house. The boy is 20 years of age. What do you expect? To pray night prayer and to fast day? He's watching Bollywood movies all the time, or watching Hollywood movies. And now they have Nollywood movies from Nigeria. I hope they don't have Sonnolud from Saudi Arabia movies. Well, this is, yani, what wood has to do with this? I don't know. Anyhow, and this is what he sees 24/7. So what do you expect? Yani, the guy to be a righteous imam or a student of knowledge? Or shaitan is messing up with his mind for the past couple of years, and he sees this, what he sees in front of him, and what do you expect? Put fire next to fuel, and you will have a big, huge fire.